Hello, welcome to our service today as we begin a new series looking at the first 12 chapters of the book of Acts. And we begin with Acts 1, where we consider what does it mean to be unleashed from lockdown? What does it mean to be set free by the Holy Spirit and sent out into the world? As we gather together online, as we come to the Lord today, I invite you to join with me as we say the words that Jesus himself taught us. Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done on earth as in heaven. Give us today our daily bread, and forgive us our sins, as we forgive those who sin against us. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For the kingdom, the power and the glory are yours, now and forever. Amen.
From the colors of water that bring life feels perfect. Other days it just ain't working. The good, the bad, the right, the wrong, and everything in between. Yo, it's crazy, amazing. We can turn our heart through the words we say. Mountains crumble with every syllable. Hope can live or die. So speak life, speak life to the dead and darkest night. Speak life, speak life when the sun won't shine and you don't know why. Look into the eyes of the brokenhearted. Watch them come alive as soon as you speak hope, you speak love, you speak. Twisted. Other days my thoughts just fall apart. I do, I don't, I will, I won't. It's like I'm drowning in the deep. Well, it's crazy to imagine words from my lips as the arms of compassion. Mountains crumble with every syllable. Hope can live or die. So speak life, speak life to the dead and darkest night. You say, raise your thoughts a little higher. Use your words to inspire. Joy will fall like rain when you speak life with the things you say. Lift your head a little higher. Spread the love like fire. Hope will fall like rain when you speak life with the words you say. So speak life, speak life to the deadest, darkest night.
Reading is from Acts chapter 1, and we're going to be reading the first 8 verses. Jesus taken up into heaven. In my former book, Theophilus, I wrote about all that Jesus began to do and to teach, until the day he was taken up to heaven, after giving instructions through the Holy Spirit to the apostles he had chosen. After his suffering, he showed himself to these men and gave many convincing proofs that he was alive. He appeared to them over a period of 40 days and spoke about the kingdom of God. On one occasion, while he was eating with them, he gave them this command: "Do not leave Jerusalem, but wait for the gift my Father promised, which you heard me speak about. For John baptized with water, but in a few days you will be baptized with the Holy Spirit." So, when they met together, they asked him, "Lord, are you at this time going to restore the kingdom to Israel?" He said to them, "It is not for you to know the times or dates the Father has set by his own authority. But you will receive power when the Holy Spirit comes on you, and you will be my witnesses in Jerusalem and in all Judea and Samaria and to the ends of the earth."
We're thinking today about these first few verses in the book of Acts. The book of Acts is Luke's second volume to his gospel. In his gospel, he said, "I too decided, after investigating everything carefully from the very first, to write an orderly account for you." This is the continuation, as I said, of that gospel. And in verse 1 of Acts, Luke says, "In my first book, I told you about everything Jesus began to do and teach." So his book of Acts is a continuation of what Jesus did and taught through the church. And today we are still continuing what Jesus began to do and teach. We today are doing and teaching also in our age. So what we are doing and teaching is a continuation of what we were doing and teaching before. We still gather as church, but in different ways. We still do the things that God has called us to. We pray. We read and study the scriptures. We enjoy fellowship. We care for one another. We still have home groups and other meetings, albeit in a different way. So this time under lockdown is a time of continuation, just as the time that Jesus was with the disciples at the beginning of Acts was a time of continuation from his earthly ministry. He'd gone through death, and he was now with them in a resurrected body, and he was still teaching them, encouraging, loving, and rebuking them when necessary. So that was a time of continuation. But it's also a time of difference. We can't deny, can we, that things are very different for us at the moment. And things were very different for the disciples at that time. They were no longer setting out with a purpose to Jerusalem, that a purpose that they didn't fully understand, even though Jesus tried to teach them about it and talk to them about it on the way. Jesus wasn't with them in the same way that he'd been with them for the last 3 years. So it's a time that's different from what's gone before, and it's a time that's different from what's going to come afterwards. We don't know what our time is going to be like after the lockdown, but we know that for the disciples, this meant them receiving the Holy Spirit and guiding and comforting them and leading them to different situations all across the world. So they knew that Jesus was with them, but only for a limited time. And God is with us in this time of difference. And it is a different time for many of us. We are stuck at home. Some people find that great. Some people find it difficult. We only make occasional forays out. We're supposed to not go shopping unless we really need to. We're not allowed to hug or shake hands with people who are not from the same household. So we have to practice physical distance. And, you know, shops have got tape on them both inside and out so that we keep our distance from other shoppers. And we have one-way systems in some shops so that we're not allowed to move forward until the person in front's gone forward. So it's all very different, isn't it? deliveries are left on our doorstep and somebody will ring the bell or knock on the door and stand back and wait to see if we pick it up. Life's not like it was. The roads are quieter for those that do have to go out. And we can't meet in person on a regular basis. Some of us have learned the value of technology and some of its limitations. We've been blessed, haven't we, with some of the photos that have been taken, particularly by the Pryor family, around West Berkshire and Greenham itself. And some of us find these times easier than others. But God is with us. Whatever is happening, wherever we're at, God is still with us. God is still God. He hasn't deserted us. And the disciples knew that God was with them at this time. But it's also a time of preparation. The disciples were learning more from Jesus and spending time with him. And he was explaining how what had happened to him was part of what had been said in the scriptures. But then he gave them an action that many of us, especially in this day and age, find quite difficult. And that action was to wait. Now, over the years, I've often prayed the Methodist prayer of the Methodist covenant prayer. And one line in that says, "Let me be employed for you or laid aside for you." Turns out that I didn't realize what being laid aside might mean. And it's not so easy. But I'm asking the Lord to help me on it. But how is God preparing us? Are we waiting? It might be all right sometimes just to be at home and to be waiting and not to be doing anything. We're bombarded if we watch TV or read the papers or look on social media at all. We're bombarded with people who are doing exciting things, maybe to raise money for charity or to help other people in the nation. And that might not be our thing. We might just feel we want to be quiet at home. And that's fine. Because God can be with us in that. And even in that, God can be deepening our spiritual experience. Maybe you have learnt a new skill during this time that God wants, that you think you could use in God's service after lockdown's over. Maybe you've revived an old skill or an old interest that you've not had time to do or be part of for a while. Maybe you're just reevaluating how you spend your time. And the Lord has a different direction for you to take when lockdown ends. Maybe you've gained new passions that you want to explore further as you go forward into the future. Whatever it is, embrace it just as the early church did. You know that the group that met with Jesus over this time and were in the upper room on the day of Pentecost were about 120. They embraced what God gave to them, or who God gave to them, which was the Holy Spirit. And they turned the world upside down. Wouldn't it be great if we could turn the world upside down today? That more people came to love and serve Jesus because of our response to the lockdown and the virus. So I say enjoy, and maybe endure. What is the same? Enjoy, and maybe enjoy. What is different? Endure. Enjoy, and maybe endure. What is different? But be excited that God is preparing you for whatever happens after the lockdown. Whatever he's got for you and for us in our corporate life as God's people in Greenham. Amen. Let your light so shine before men that they may see your good works and glorify your Father which is in heaven.
Heard the mystery, you crossed the great divide to show your love for me, as you hung upon the cross and spilled your blood for me. And now I see my sin that held you there, it has no hold on me. Rose again, and now you have the victory. Forever I will say thank you, thank you for the cross. How I love you, Jesus. You have won my heart. This is love. This is love.
Forever I will say thank you, thank you, thank you. Theophilus, the lover of God. I'm writing to you again, my friend, to give fuller details of the life of Jesus and all the things he did. Over the next few weeks in these online talks and videos, we're going to be looking at the book of Acts. The book of Acts is a letter speaking about all the things that Jesus did through his disciples. And I was wondering, what have you been up to? What have you been doing? And how's God been using you over the last few weeks? This week, we received a letter from a good friend of ours, talking all about the things that she'd been up to. I'm wondering if you could write a letter. You could talk about the things that you've been up to. Maybe talk about Easter. Maybe share your prayers, the pleas and the thank yous that we wrote together and we put online. If you haven't got things that you think you've been up to, you might want to think about things that you'd like to do, your hopes for the future. Or maybe look back and think about good memories and write them down. You can always draw great pictures. It's always nice to have fun pictures in letters. Maybe it might be worth just praying and asking God who you could send that letter to and encourage them about everything that's going on.
Church, we pray, we buy.
And as we come to the end of our service, a prayer of blessing. Go forth into the world in peace. Be of good courage. Hold fast to that which is good. Render to no one evil for evil. Strengthen the faint-hearted. Support the weak. Help the afflicted. Honour everyone. Love and serve the Lord, rejoicing in the power of the Holy Spirit. And the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be on you and all those you love, today and always. Amen.